So let's talk about your career a little bit. So where did you start?
I started in Chicago when I first graduated from undergrad.
Mm-hmm.
I started working in an architecture engineering firm
mm-hmm.
for 2 years. And that's kind of how I decided I needed to go to grad school. Because once I started working, I realized like this is not what I want to do. Like there's no way that I started, you know, that I spent all these years in a school for this.
And what was this? What do you mean by this?
I think it was just, you know how it is. Once you get out of a school, architecture, I think there is a big disconnect between architecture school and architecture as it is practicing architecture in the real world. When you're in architecture school, you spend so much time where you're being molded to think a certain way, to think about yourself almost like an artist that is creating. And then once you go into an office, it's usually there's a paycheck associated, there's hours associated, there's red lines, there's all these things, you know, that doesn't seem so related to creating.
Right.
And mostly going from architecture school to an architecture engineering firm.
Mm-hmm.
The job that I was doing, it was very, there was a lot of technicality to it. It was really interesting, but it was mostly interesting from an engineering point of view. I was working in particle accelerators.
Right.
Like light source facilities, which are amazing. I mean, those things are amazing products. They're these like fantastic machines. But in terms of architecture, there's not that creative, you know.
It wasn't feeling what you wanted to do. Yeah. It wasn't doing it for you.
Right. But I also didn't know what I wanted to do. Mm. I just felt like I needed to discover something else.
Mm-hmm. So you decided to go to school.
So I decided to go back to school and to go to grad school. And this time it wasn't going to be because I need to get a diploma anymore, because I didn't need that anymore. Mm. It was, I'm going to go and find my passion and I'm going to really enjoy it.
Gotcha.
And I want to be surrounded by, you know, amazing minds and like follow amazing professors and have discussions and like really enjoy my time there.
Mm-hmm. How did you know that architecture was, like, the masters of architecture was going to be that for you?
I was just trying, you know.
Okay.
I thought that that's what it would be, because you meet amazing architects that can be very inspiring. They're taking it from somewhere, and I just wanted to be surrounded by those minds, because that's another thing. Sometimes you go to an office, and all these passionate conversations that you had during your career, all of a sudden they evaporate.
Right.
And it's like, no, it's about the bathroom, or it's about the door, or it's about this. And you're like, no, but it has to be about something else.
Right.
Because, you know, you taught me to think this way. And now what do I do with all this energy that is in my brain? So, right.
Right, right. It can be so limiting. Yeah. I mean, do you think there's a solution to that? Like, what do we do about it?
I think the part of the solution comes within, to tell you the truth.
Mm-hmm.
Comes, you know, like there has to be, you have to believe that, and you have to believe in yourself and be passionate about it.
Mm-hmm.
Because, you know, discussions don't just happen. It's not like everybody just like can bring it up to you. It's like you have to create them, you know, like mm-hmm. it's also up to you to stay excited.
Yeah.
And if you find yourself in an environment that is like, okay, this is not that exciting, then you have, it's up to you to decide, you know, what other steps can you take.
Mm-hmm.